studying room is to figure out how I can market this, and it would be great, and every deer hunter thinks this is the case, it's all chops, right? Okay, don't get me into the chops, all around all chops, it's the same with this animal. Okay, we know that we can sell what we call high on the hog eating, that's where that phrase comes, living high on the hog, you live higher on the animal, you're eating higher on the animal, that's the better, more tender cuts. True here too, these muscles don't do as much, they're more tender, they run along the back, they're just supporting the animal. Okay, so if I've got these muscles along the back, that's great, those are steaks, that only accounts for about a third of the carcass. Okay, at best, about a third of the carcass. And so we need to resolve the value of this carcass, knowing that this doesn't have a problem selling, with the stuff we have a harder time moving in volume. Okay, one carcass, not a problem. 10,000 carcasses, big problem. If you can't move these at the same rate. And so we've got to assign a value to these based on that. And so if I have to drive down the value of the front and back of the animal, because it won't move as fast, that means I have to drive up the price of the middle meats, okay, as break even is concerned.